Very warm good evening, ladies and gentlemen, all our viewers across the globe. Welcome to the studio of M4 TV live in Melbourne. COVID-19. Every around the world, the same word has been going on. Corona or either COVID-19. The impact which has created to the economics, to the human history has been really disaster. Really being dreadful. Each and every country has been affected. Thousands are being dead. More than millions are being keep on getting affected day after other. No country ever in the world has been spared. Most of the big cities, including London, Mumbai, Milan, Melbourne, Sydney, New York, has been shut. Airports have been closed. COVID is being really getting into every field, irrespective where you are. Can't say that you are safe. It has gone even to the most safest place in the world, which is a British Prime Minister has been tested positive for COVID-19. So no one is being spared. All what you can do is listen to what the government has to tell you. Stay safe, be home. That's the only option up to this stage. Into our TV studio. Keeping every precautions what our Victorian government and Australian government has given us. Keeping away, keeping safe, keeping stay, being staying at home. We having our exclusive guests live from their home into our studios. Today, we have a very special selected person. A social and political activities in Melbourne. A great community leader. It's not only a specified community from a state, but you can see him every communities, whether it's been Gujarati, whether it's been Punjabi, whether it's been Tamil, Telang, Malayali, anywhere, a most famous face in Melbourne. A great personality who's been fighting for real causes of the people who are in need. At this scenario, at this stage, the man who's been really fighting hard for the international students, for the students who are in need, who are desperately need a help in Australia, the man who's been fighting up. The man who's been standing up for each and every reason what they require. You can see, you may have seen, noticed, many organizations, many religious and political and communities have come up. But we have picked up someone very special who have really made a mark into the international students' life. And here, we welcome the most important man for today. Let's connect Mr. Karthik Arasu. Welcome, Mr. Karthik.
Thank you, Finney. Thank you so much for having me. And thank you for your generous introduction in the beginning of the episode. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you, Karthik Arasu, for giving us your time over for us in Let's Connect. COVID-19, you know, whenever you have a trickle in your throat, it makes you remind of a word corona, which makes up corona. So how it's being affecting your lifestyle as a person, as a community leader?
It's affected me the same way it's affected everyone. And it's like it's across the place, wherever I go and who I meet, which we do it very low nowadays because of only essential work, we need to go out. And it's the same way it's impacted our work and also the lifestyle. And the fear it's brought into all of us, you know, the effect has been unimaginable. But we are trying to get into grips now, and the government has been great in putting out all the health advices every day. And so we are more aware of it now to what to do and what not to do. And most of the time we are in self-isolation, even though we are not directly impacted by the corona, so which is keeping us safe. And as you see, I can see like most of them are working from home. And everyone's lifestyle has changed completely within the short span of few weeks. At the start, it was very difficult to cope up with this, but now everyone is getting into this routine and everyone is starting to find out ways how we can best utilize in this given scenario. And it's making much better now. And so you can see the impact is also reducing in our lives and we are getting on with it now.
That's great. So based on the current scenario, current situation, which was released on the Australian Statistics Report at 433 GST, which says that 5,988 positive cases in Australia. Government has been telling, flattening the curve. What do you think? Has it's being effectively worked out in Australia?
It is working in its own pace, but it's much better than compared to other parts of the world. I think it's two parts to it. One is the government, which has been putting out the advertisements of advisories, I would say, advisories of what to do, how to do it. And they have been very strict about it in enforcing it. It would be the on-the-spot fines, or be bringing out every single day to our computer screens or TV screens or even the phones. So the government is doing their job. And the big part is by us, the community. We have taken it very seriously, and we are maintaining the distance. When I went to purchase my groceries, essential groceries, everybody is standing that 1.5 meters away, and everybody is doing it on their own. There is no need of policing. People themselves are doing it. And I think that is the main reason the curve is starting to bend down, and it's almost flattening now. Very soon we will flatten the curve. And I think the majority of the success goes to the community itself for taking it on board and doing it effectively.
That's really wonderful. To our statistical quotes, actually, which shows that Victoria has done much, much better when compared to the other states in Australia. What's your thoughts on that?
Yes, it's really pleasing to see that. A lot more need to be done, but it's very good to see when the community has understood what the impact is and actioned it. They are not waiting for government to come and enforce it, or they're not waiting for the government to come and keep on preaching them. The community has taken it on board, and they are doing it by themselves. So because the government cannot do this, every single one of them. So that this is completely the community's success, and it's really pleasing to see that Victoria is leading Australia in this regards.
Considering the facts, you know, when other countries has gone into a complete lockdown, even though which we have been seeing into the medias, Australia hasn't done such a thing. Our Prime Minister hasn't closed completely into a lockdown stage. Do you think he should have done that, or what's your viewpoint on that?
Initially, I was also one of the few, many who thought, actually, why can't we do a lockdown like other countries are going up? But I think in Australia, a lockdown, looking at what's happening now, we are essentially in a partial lockdown. We have enforced it on ourselves. And if the government completely shut everything down, it's going to cause more trouble. And I think it will cause more panic in the future. Right now, what we are on, it's working. It's working better than the lockdowns, actually. Some countries which has gone into lockdowns, they are doing good, but we have to compare the population. We have to compare the demographics there. So I think what we are doing right now is working. And I don't think a lockdown is essential at this stage, because we are starting to see the dip in the curve. And people have taken it on board, as I said. The community is doing everything essentially possible to maintain this safe distance and all these safety procedures. So I think the government has taken a good step in the long run, which we will see very soon.
That's really good to hear that from D. Karthiki. That's really good when you are from a South India, one of the states from South India. I believe you're from Tamil Nadu. And keeping up to the pace of 1.29 billion people of India, which is being locked down for 21 days. And Kerala, one of the greenery states, God's own country, it's been really doing much well. What's your thought on that? You know, has it been really effective what the government of India has been doing?
Yes, I think for a country like India with such a big population, and also taking the message across to the very remote parts of the India of how to be safe and self-isolating themselves, it's a tough task. A lockdown is very essential in India, and I think it's a really big kudos to the Indian government of taking this bold step of shutting the country down, closing all their borders, and also locking down this thing. Yes, there might be some other debates on how it's to be done, but we are in no position to judge that. The government and the leadership will know what can be done effectively. And I think Kerala, as you mentioned, is doing much better now. Initially, they were going through a lot of cases. Now they are starting to get into a control. I think they are showing India how to be done in a way. Even Tamil Nadu, I'm from Tamil Nadu. Even Tamil Nadu is doing much effective ways, and they're doing the checks, spot checks, and checking on people more effectively. And those news are really heartwarming to see, because anyway, we are here, but still our families are back home. And we always think of them and worry about them, what's going to happen. So this step is very essential for India. And I think it's working, and it will work on the long run as well. Yes, there will be some issues. Like, it will come out of any of these drastic measures. There will be some issues, but it will be really sorted out quickly. If the lockdown didn't happen, it would have been disastrous for India, in my opinion.
That's really good to hear that. You know, what do you think about the police action and the military actions, which is we could see in the media from India, being very strict to the people who have been wandering on the streets? When I was looking on the statistics, a country of 1.3 billion people with 5,600 positive cases, and a country, Australia, with 2.7 million people with 5,988 cases. So really, who is flattening the curve? Is it really the curve has been getting flattened?
If you compare that way, India is doing much better. But if you see an organic drop, Australia is doing much better, because our peak is gone and we are reducing in the percentages every day, new cases. In India, new cases are starting to come up now because of various reasons. But you can't compare just by population and just by the demographic alone, because each country has got its own set of issues and set of advantages. In India, they closed down the border very soon. I think that is a big more than lockdown. Indian government shut down the border and cancelled all flights. I think that was one of the best decisions they took. Australia, we didn't do that. We should have shut down our border. I think our border is still not shut down. So we allowed a lot of people to come back in without any checks initially. I think that led to where we are today. I'm pretty sure the government had their own reasons, valid reasons, which we are not privy to. They would have taken the call at what is best at that given time. But I think on a hindsight, if Australia enforced 14-day compulsory self-isolation of whoever came into Australia way before than now, we would have been in a much better situation than we are today. Regardless of all these things, it's working now, and we are starting to flatten the curve. That's what's important.
That's a really good thing. That's a really good news coming up from Australia. They are really trying hard. The government of Australia is being really trying hard. Even the old states government are really being in touch, being in really cooperative with Australian government, doing the best for the citizens of Australia. It's been really great to hear that. Your viewpoints are being really very, very useful and beneficial for Australian community, and especially for Indian community over here. You are a well-known face I had been seeing. I would like to know, our viewers would like to know, you know, we have been hearing a lot about you being in Australia as a businessman and as a community leader. How is it working out?
I'm passionate about serving the community. More than calling myself a community leader, I'd like to call myself a community ambassador. So when I represent my community, I want to be proud, and my community, I want to share the same pride with every single one of them in our community. And my activism, be it political or social activism, it's always in the betterment for the community. It's always in the benefit of the community. And we've been working so closely, and friends like you have been very helpful in supporting us and also motivating us every day. And every single one of them is doing some way, like you mentioned at the beginning of the introduction about the international students issues. Right now, when this COVID started impacting, one of the major impacts was for the international student community. And as you know, there's hundreds of thousands of students here studying, leaving their home country and studying here in Australia. And now they are suddenly cut off from the rest of the world, pretty much from their home. Some are not receiving any funds from back home, because majority of the students coming from India or China. In India, the banks, everything is shut down and they can't transfer money. So they are going through a lot of stress, both financially and also mentally, with this issue. And the community, every single one of them, has come out and said, put their hand up, and they said they are there for them. And they don't need, they're not, you know, openly doing it. Some are openly doing it. Some are just doing it on their own on a very quiet level. But every single one of them from our community has been in the forefront doing some help or the other. So I'm really proud and happy and blessed to be belonging to this community, such a vibrant and wonderful community, which is the Indian Australian community. And I think our community is great in doing that.
That's really great. Karthik, you may have seen, even based on our research, at this stage due to COVID-19, we would see a lot of posts from community organization, from political organization back in India, and from individuals in Facebooks and Instagrams. We are there to help you every time. Even if you need financially, if you need a job, if you need mental support, we are there. But when we did a research, most of them are just for the popularity. And we have, based on our research, we came across that Karthik Arasu is a person who's been doing something out of the box, ticking each and every box in a different way. That's the reason you are right here with Let's Connect. So how you are being able to do it? Are you doing it as a person, as you're part of community? Our viewers would like to know that.
So I'm just part of, I'm just a small part of a big team, you know, and the community is a big team in our views. And as you mentioned, there will be always someone who wants to do it for various different reasons. You know, we are not here to criticize them. So if that's what makes them to help others, so be it, you know. But what I do is, we are a group of people who just came along together from different organizations. It's not one single organization. Initially, when I saw this, I started writing to all the university vice chancellors and also to the government. I've written to the ministers of education, minister of immigration minister, the Assistant Multicultural Minister, treasurer, and also to all the vice chancellors of all the universities with our set of appeal. So we've been starting to do that, and a lot of people from our community joined together, and they started doing this help. We provided groceries, or we connected people who can provide food. It's not only I am doing it, I'm just a small part channeling in a big team who are doing voluntarily, who are putting their work behind and then doing this work. I'm just a face, one of the faces, which is representing them. That's all. And everybody is doing a fantastic job. And as I said, so proud to be a part of the team.
That's really good to hear that, Karthik. What's your best advice you would love to give us, our viewers, in this really drastic period of COVID-19?
Okay. My first message is for the international students who are here, and they are panicking a lot with various news and headlines coming out, and they're thinking that they need to go back and that's the life is over here in Australia, they can't study anymore. None of them is correct. They're going to be here, and they're going to be part of our community, and they are very much needed here in Australia, and the community is behind them. We are all behind them. We will support them in any which way possibly we can, and we are there for you. When I say we, I'm talking about the entire community is there for you. We will support you in any which way possible. So don't worry, if you're a student here, just concentrate on your studies, and please make sure that you tell your families back home that our community is behind us and you don't have to worry about it. And for our general community, I'm so proud to be a part of this, such a vibrant community, because in times of these devastation, be it the bushfire or now with COVID, we have been out and about in supporting and helping from the tiniest of the way to the big things, you know, and people serving one box of food or to groceries or to rent accommodation, free accommodation in their home. People have opened their houses. People have opened their wallets. It's just unimaginable how the help is coming from every part of the community. And what I would like to say to the community is, thank you so much. I am blessed to be part of this community, and you guys are motivating us every single day. And thank you so much. Keep doing what you're doing. Support each other. And we have to stand together, not only for this, every time, so that we can be successful.
Thank you, Karthik Arasu. Thanks a lot for giving us your precious time for Let's Connect. It was really great talking to you. Keep doing your great work. You are useful into our community. The country like Australia needs people like you. Thank you once again for joining us. Thank you, viewers. Thanks a lot.